Bill Tilson with Gorilla Fabrication, and today we're going to show you one of our newest food trucks. This is for Melania Durant here in Charleston, South Carolina, doing pastries, baked goods, and breakfast items. This food truck has a serving window and a shelf. We'll both pop out, undo these three toggles, open it up, lift them both, and now they're open. Grab the strap here, shut them down, and they both close together. Now we'll show you the inside of the truck. So this is the interior of the truck. It originally had a roll-up door, so we went ahead and took that off and put this walk door in. So it locks, it's just a regular entry door that we fabricated here. As you can see when you walk in, it's very brightly lit inside here. We use all LED lighting to give you a lot more lumens with a lot less power consumption. 60-pound propane cylinder. This will also hold a 100-pound propane cylinder if that's what the customer chooses to do, but right now it's set up for 60. So we've redone the entire truck. You can see the lights up top. All of the mounts for the lights have been taken off, repainted the entire truck, stripped of its old paint, and redone. This is actually a 1978 step van. So you'll see the pictures of the before and notice how much nicer it is with all the trim in this cream, the whole truck repainted in blue. It's a pretty nice paint job for a food truck. It won't require a wrap. We'll end up doing graphics on here out of vinyl instead of hiding the look of this entire truck. Little window for ventilation in here. You can still see out. It helps with security, but also on those hot days you can open it up. Speaking of hot days, we do have a lot of them here in South Carolina, so almost all of our food trucks we do install with a 15,000 BTU roof unit. It's very helpful when you're prepping, setting up, or cleaning up, although when the hood's on, you're not going to get much use out of it. So this truck has a 4-foot under-counter refrigerator with a worktop. So there's a lot of storage in here. It'll take full sheet pans on the top, dough boxes on the bottom, and lots of counter space to work on. Again, this is a pastry truck, so the speed rack here for all your trays of dough, your croissants, your muffins, all the like. It's a countertop convection oven, a compact unit, but it'll do an awful lot without the size of the big conventional convection ovens. Plenty of storage right below it, so there's lots of room on this truck. So right here you have the serving window. We're going to open up the awning there. So here you have, in South Carolina, you're required to have a 2-foot by 2-foot opening. That's the max size you can have, and it must be self-closing. So what we do here, when it drops, you walk away, it is self-closing. It only really operates like that, so if the customer wants, they can just put a hook up on the ceiling, and the window stays open. Plenty of clearance for the server to access the customers on the ground. Little shelf right here. When you tray your orders up, you can easily get them out. Get more storage, just worktop. Anywhere that you don't have equipment in these trucks, you really ought to have a worktop. It just makes it a lot easier to get product together, stage, even dishes that you're going to wash, have hot product coming off, and a place to plate it. So being a pastry truck and having two burners and a small flat top, not doing a whole lot of cooking in here, along with the oven. There's a large mixer in here for doing all the doughs, and to be able to wash the different mixing balls that you'll have in here and the attachments, put an extra large sink in here. So it's a big 3-basin sink. It's bigger than what's on most trucks, but thankfully it is an 18-foot box where it will fit this item in here. A separate hand wash sink right there. Comes with hot water. It's your hot water heater. Runs on propane, D-cell batteries for the igniter. So it doesn't require any electricity other than the two batteries. Again, keeping your wattage down on your generator. Right here we have a butcher block top. We have pastries, rolling dough, all the other stuff that you'll do in a pastry truck. That's a John Moose top that's also removable. It makes it nice for cleaning. So you can just take this block away and you have a stainless steel worktop right underneath it. But a lot of bakers like to have the wood for doing their doughs and the like. Everything underneath here, you have some supplemental storage, your pumps, your tanks, connection for your water heater, all of that's in this oversized cabinet. All your cleaning supplies can go down here. Any other items that aren't necessarily food related, but that you need to keep on your truck. You got a 1400 CFM exhaust fan right here. Lights come on, so does the fan. So we built all of these hoods here to size. So they're custom made in our shop at Gorilla Fabrication. Again, 12 volt for all the lighting. Gives you a nice clean white look. You can see the difference in these LED lights versus the DHEC and Fire Marshal required explosion-proof lights. Maybe one day they'll let us go to LED in there, but these fixtures are what's required. So you can, again, see the difference between fluorescent and LED. So to power this whole truck, there's a 7,000-watt Cummins RBE generator. The 7,000-watt Cummins RBE generator puts out 120-volt or 240-volt, depending on the application. The nice thing about these generators is they've got a remote start. So right here in the cockpit, you could be driving and start your generator. Let's hit it again here. And now we have a generator that is on. Right now the truck is actually on shore power. All of our vehicles are built that way so that you can have the access to plug in at your event or at your commissary and not have to run the generator. Ideally that's how you would operate the truck. You only use the generators to keep your refrigerators running while in transit. But flexibility is important, so we set it up so that you can have either shore power or run off the generator. Used to be a Mayflower delivery truck filling people's homes, and now it's a pastry truck for filling people's stomachs. So you should have a lot of success here in Charleston operating this vehicle.